this is a multi-year grant.
2020 will bring about a massive undertaking for the city of Indianapolis and IMPD.
It's very labor intensive. It's going to take a lot of time and a lot of effort to do this.
I sat down with Investigative Division Major Catherine Cummings to find out more about a $1.4 million grant awarded by the Department of Justice as part of what's called the National Sexual Assault Kit Initiative. The money will help IMPD figure out how many of these sexual assault kits exist across Marion County and how many have never been tested.
That's the first step of the grant, is the audit, and that's to look at what do you have, what has been tested, what has been partially tested, why or why not, what is still valid for testing.
Over the past decade, communities across the country have begun testing old kits, in some cases leading to DNA hits and long-awaited justice for survivors.
How can we?
That's why advocates like Kristen Polisi and the Indiana Coalition to End Sexual Assault have pushed for more testing.
We have precedent in other states, such as Ohio, that shows that you're catching serial rapists this way.
The state of Indiana released its own audit of untested kits 2 years ago, but Marion County only submitted 1 year's worth of data. We did more digging and found out that less than half of the kits collected in the county are tested.
We applied for this money.
Major Cummings confirmed that as part of the grant, the city will look at possible changes to policy moving forward.
If the community says we want this and we can't change it that day, it doesn't mean that we're not listening and that we're not looking for ways to make those changes that the community is asking for.
The grant money will pay to hire a coordinator and staff at the crime lab in IMPD, since more testing could mean more investigations. Cummings says the crime lab and prosecutor's office helped decide to apply for the grant, and their goal is to work together as part of a process that is designed to bring justice to the people behind the kits.
That's what matters most, utilizing our resources in the best way and taking care of the people who have been victimized.
Now, as of earlier this year, the state is now individually tracking every sexual assault kit. And Debbie, that's so that survivors can actually see where their kit is in the process and if it has been tested.
Yeah, that's critically important to those folks. And talking about the survivors, you've been covering this for what, 2 years now?
Yeah.
What does this mean for the survivors if they think their case has gone cold?
Well, a big part of it is that the ultimate goal is to test more kits and possibly bring more of these cases to prosecution. Mm-hmm. Now, the next step after the city finishes the audit is going to be looking at each individual case. So they will have to look case by case. And we're talking about years of work here, so we'll keep an eye on the progress.
All right, Jill Glavin, thank you.